Okay, next we have to find the square root of these type of numbers. So this is a mixed fraction. We will convert it into the fraction. It becomes 6 upon 5. So when you divide 6 by 5, you will get 1.2. Okay, so again we will find the square root of this 1.2. That is 1.2. We will put 1 0 here. 1 for 1 pair. Then 1 pair after decimal. Then again. And yeah, we like this. So nearest square of 1 is 1. 1 minus 1 will be 0. Bring 20 here. 2. Okay, you cannot put 1 here because it will give you 21 into 1, that is 21. So instead, again, what you will do, you will put a 0. And since it is decimal values have started, so we will put a decimal and 0 will come here. So it is 20. Then again we will bring that pair, 00. Now this becomes 20. So we will look for the values nearest to 2000, and I found this 209 into 9. So it will give you 1881. So it is your value 1881. And when you subtract it, you will get 119. And last pair will come here. Then you will bring 9, 218. Then it is, I have taken 5. So it is 5. So 10925. Subtract it, you will get 975. So that means square root of this 1 by 5 is approximately 1.095. And we rounded off till 9, so it becomes 1.10. Okay, so this will be the square root of 1 whole 1 by 5. This is the question. So it will be 13 upon 4, that is 3.25. so same method we will use, 3.25. 10 we will put here, then 1 pair here, then here again, then here, so like this. So okay, nearest square of 3 is 1. Then bring this 1 here, it becomes 2. Then we will look for the values, so 8, and we will put a decimal, 8. Subtract it, you will get. Then again bring this 0 here, plus 8 will give you 36. So if you put 1 after 36, this will be your number, then it becomes 361. So what we will do, same way we will put a 0. So it is 0, then last pair will come. Okay, now we will put here 2. So it becomes 72. Like this. Okay, so that means the square root of 3 1 by 4 is approximately equal to how much? 1.802. And when you round it off this 0, you will get 1.809. So this is how you can calculate the value of square root of the numbers which are in the fractions. Suppose we have to find the square root of this value. Okay, so one more method to solve the questions likes of this. What you can do, you can multiply and divide by the denominator, so you will get 186 upon 36. So that means square root of 5 1 by 6 is equals to square root of 186 upon 36. So that means it is square root of 186 upon 6. So basically we have to find now square root of 186. So how do we find square root of 186? Same method we will use, that long division method we will use again. 186. So this is 0. 1 into 1, 0. Then we will bring this 86, and after decimal again we will put the 6 zeros. Then 1 plus 1, 2. Okay, like this. Then we will bring one of the zeros, one next pair here. So it becomes 23 plus 3, that is 26. Then let's put 6 here. So you will get 1596, and we will put the decimal. And 6 will come here, so it is 401. Okay, then again we will bring this pair, then again this 6 will come here, like this, 272. So let's put the 3 here, so 3, 6, then again 3 will come here, it becomes 2726, and this pair will come here, 00. So let's put 8. So when you put this value 8, you will get 4956. So that means it is approximately 13.638 divided by 6. So when you divide it by 6, what you will get? So this is your approximate value, this we have taken. So now we will round it off this 7, so you will get 2.27. Okay, so this is another method to solve the problems of square root. Okay, and this method is valid or applicable whenever you have the denominators like 6, 3, which are not terminating decimals. Okay, in case of the questions like of this, where you have the terminating decimals like this, you can use the long division method. Or in the questions likes of this, where you got the values which are not terminating, you can use the method like of this. Okay, so this is how we will find the value of square root of the numbers which are not a perfect square. And this is the end of your chapter. Solutions I have sent you. If you have any doubt, you can ask on my WhatsApp number. Thank you.